adventurers is here. Harold Robbins' sensational bestseller. Now the screen's most incredible entertainment. The Adventurers is here. All of it. All of them. Dax. Sue Ann. Fat Cat. Amparo. The beautiful people. The violent people.
Run!
These are the adventurers. Searching for passion. Reaching for power.
Hey, Barry Bowe here. Welcome to my podcast. First off, if you think my mouth looks funny, it does. I'm trying to disguise the fact that I broke off a couple front teeth. So my face time will be minimal until some cosmetic adjustments are made. This is a low budget, no frills, no bullshit podcast. Today's wardrobe is from a Brian's run that I made more than 30 years ago. And yes, there's some paint spots on it from some do-it-yourself work around the house. And oh yeah, I must always wear a baseball cap, have since I was a little kid. And we might have a cat or two popping in every once in a while. I'll be covering all aspects of crime fiction, true crime, some sports, some current events and politics, but just a warning, like Superman, I believe in truth, justice, and the American way. Now, if you're wondering what that intro was, that's the original trailer from 1970s blockbuster movie, The Adventurers. Here's two of the stars, although I can't pronounce this guy's name, so let me spell it. B-E-K-I-M-F-E-H-M-I-U. He's a Kosovo Albanian actor. So let's go right to the Albanian translator to pronounce it.
Beckham Famiu.
That's he sitting on the bed, and there's Olivia de Havilland, a big star back in the day. She played Melanie in Gone with the Wind. She's standing in the background, and they just finished playing Nakahoma, code talk for they were having sex. And we also have Candace Bergen and Ernie Borgnine. I used a picture from McHale's Navy. And if you're wondering why I'm using the Adventurers trailer, here's why. One of my first real jobs after college took me to New York City. The year was 1968, Manhattan. And I lived in an apartment at 35 East 35th Street. That's 35th and Park Avenue to any non-New Yorkers out there. That's right, Park Avenue in New York City. And here's a picture I took of the old building a few years back. That's maybe three blocks from the Empire State Building on 5th Avenue. And my office was across the street from the Empire State and down about two blocks. And during my breaks, I used to hang with the switchboard operator. Her name was Tony, an Italian girl from Atlantic City. Man, you should see the way switchboard operators used to work. Their hands flying all over the place, plugging in every new call that came in, unplugging when the calls ended. And get this, they answered every call that came in. Can you imagine that? You call a company and a real person answers and takes care of your phone call. Anyway, Tony loved rock and roll music. That was our common ground. Plus, we were both young. I was 25. She was a year or two older. She also liked to read. And one day she brought in her copy of The Adventurers, a bestseller written by Harold Robbins. Now, I gotta tell you, before that, I never read a book for enjoyment. You know, back in school, I read stuff like Shakespeare, The Red Badge of Courage, Tom Sawyer, Beowulf, Tale of Two Cities, but I never liked any of those books. Just read them because I had to. So I take The Adventurers home, start reading it that night, and I fall in love. In fact, I love it so much, I decide right then and there that I'm going to be a fiction writer, you know, someday. And why did I make that decision? First off, I like the story. There's plenty of action, plenty of sex, and there's words in there like shit and fuck. And that did it for me. I mean, if you can write a story using words like shit and fuck and wind up with a bestseller, I'm in. even though it's going to take another 20 years before I make the move. As we go along and get to know each other, I'll fill in some of the blanks. My plan is 3 podcasts per week, short and snappy, about 10 minutes each, shooting for Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and perhaps, if it develops and catches on, we'll add some guests and some co-hosts, maybe even expand the time. And I'll use a minute or so to plug one of my books. I have a new book just hitting the market. It's called Cleopatra Murdered. It's actually a fictional adaptation of my outlaw biker saga, Born to be Wild, where I start at the beginning of the true story and then just let my imagination run wild. It's a short, snappy, quick-hitting read, and right now, it's available at Amazon. So, thanks for tuning in today. Until next time, see you, and that's a wrap.